Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about the characteristics of sound waves. Till now you have studied the what is wave, what are wave motions. Okay, so you are going to study, you have already studied about the characteristics of wave, but here in short we will study about the characteristics of wave and how it is produced. Okay, how you are going to define such all the characteristics that we are going to study today. Okay, so what are the, as you know, what is a wave? Wave, it's a disturbance in any medium. If there is any disturbance, if in a calm pond, you have I have explained to you that if you are throwing a stone, what happens? There is a disturbance. Okay, so what are they actually? They are the waves. So some characteristics of waves, there are. That is, if the wave, how the wave is produced, first I will explain that, then we will go for the this characteristics. Okay, now here you can see a speaker is there. I have explained you about the ringing bell. Here I have taken the speaker. Speaker, you know, when you start on the speaker, what happens? It will produce the sound. Okay, when the sound is produced, as we have studied, when the sound is produced, what happened? It makes the air particle nearby to vibrate. Okay, here I have written, I have drawn in three conditions. First, I have drawn for the density of air particles, then I have drawn for pressure created in the air particles, and third one, the wave related to this two I have drawn here. Now when the speaker is on, if you are talking about density, then what you can see here, when the speaker is on, that time you can see air particle, there is refraction. When the speaker starts, what happened? The energy or the sound which is coming out from the speaker makes the particle to move to and fro motion. Okay, that time you can see the particles here, it gets hit by each other. So you can see this is one row, two row, three row of air particles, just you can consider for your understanding. So when the sound hits the one row of particle, it go and collide to another row of particle, then to and fro it is moving. Okay, then again back. So when it hits to the another set of the air particle, that time it transfers in energy, or you can also say it's sound. It transfers it to second row. Like this, they are emitting, they are passing the sound. Okay, so at one point, if they come together, they form a high density particle. If they go away, you can see there it becomes low density. So according to that, you can see if the particles are low, means if there is low or small amount of particles together, that term is called as refraction. And second condition, you can see compressed, means more air particles come together. So that region is called as compression. Like this, alternately you can see rarefaction, compression, rarefaction, compression, rarefaction, compression, and finally it reaches to the eardrum. Okay, it reaches to the eardrum like this. So this was for the density. Density is shown by the small air particles. So I have drawn it in the dots form. Now you are going to talk about pressure. In the pressure, you can see that same I am drawing. Okay, same pattern I am keeping. Refraction, refraction, compression, refraction. Same pattern I am showing. Okay, but now it is in the line form. Why line form? I am going to show here pressure. What is the relation of density and pressure in such wave forms? Okay, if there is refraction, refraction means low density. Low density means low pressure. Okay, so here lines I have shown little bit apart. Okay, here compressed air particles means high density, so air pressure, so the pressure will be also high over there. If it is high pressure, then compression lines I am showing closely to each other. Again rarefaction, if there is a rarefaction, then again here also rarefaction. If more molecules are come together, means high density, then high pressure also, this term is very important. If there is more or less density, then pressure is also less at that place. Okay, means high density, high pressure, it is called as compression. Low density, low pressure, it is called as rarefaction. Okay, so this was about density, pressure. Now I have drawn a graph related to this density and pressure. Okay, on this y-axis I have taken density and pressure. On x-axis I have taken the distance, how the wave is traveling, so that distance I have taken. Now I am going to convert this compression rarefaction into the form of wave. As I have explained you, your density here it is less, rarefaction pressure is also less. So what happens? So as it is less, so it will come here, rarefaction is shown below the line. So I have shown here, till here I have shown the rarefaction. Here again it is showing compression. So what happens? As here high density, higher density, high pressure, so the peak will be high. So again it comes at high. Again it is rarefaction, so again it will come below. Then again compression, so it will come at high. So this way the wave is drawn. Okay, that's why it is said as the sound is a wave. Okay, or sound travels in a wave pattern as light travels in a straight line. Okay, so this waveform we have drawn using these two conditions. Okay, now names you are going to study, some terms you are going to study related to such waves. Okay, now first term is the wavelength. So what is the wavelength? It is the length of wave. Now here some students have confusion that how here it is shown like this, then otherwise you can also study the wave. Or for your understanding, I am showing this is one wave. From here till here, it is one wave. Okay, so this from here till here also you can consider it as lambda, means wavelength. You can consider this way also, or you can consider from the point to point. That is, if there is like this two waves, you can also consider this peak to peak. This is also considered as the wavelength. This two manner you can consider lambda, as you know it is denoted by the letter lambda. So here this is the one wave. It can also be called as wavelength. This way also you can find, or you can find with this peak to peak. Okay, that is also a wavelength. So here I have shown this way, that is lambda. Its unit is meters. As a very simple, you can keep in mind, as it is length, you can keep in mind that the unit is meter. Okay, now second term is the frequency. Frequency means what? How many numbers of waves are produced in per unit time. For example, in 1 second, how many waves are produced here? Here you can see, as I have told you, this one wave, two, three. Okay, three, and this one and half of you can consider as four. So here frequency is four. For example, how many waves are produced? That is your frequency. I am drawing here. Now here how many frequency is there? You can find, see, count the wave. This is the one wave, two wave, three wave, four wave. So here frequency is four. Okay, it is very simple. How many waves are from? That is your frequency. So frequency, it is denoted by letter nu. Here this nu letter is nu for you. This is way you will write the nu, nu, nu. Okay, until now you have studied that frequency is n or f, but now from here you will study that frequency is nu. This is a Greek letter, so the frequency. So I have written nu equal to 4. That is number of, that is frequency is 4. Here how much frequency is there? If I will draw, now here two waves I have drawn. Okay, 1 and 2. So what will be the frequency here? As there are two waves, so frequency will be 2. Understood? So this is the frequency in this wave. Frequency is the number of waves formed in per unit time. That is called frequency. It is denoted by the letter nu. And what is the unit? Unit is hertz. This is very important. Frequency unit. The unit of frequency is hertz. And it is denoted by letter capital H, small z. And who has given this name? It is given on the name of Heinrich Hertz. Okay, he has discovered this frequency term, so the name was given on his name. Okay, now you are going to study about amplitude. What is amplitude? Now here you can see height of the peak. Okay, this one is the peak. Here from the mean position to the maximum displacement, that is called amplitude. Here this is the amplitude of the peak. This is the amplitude, means height of the peak. From its middle point to the maximum point, that is the height of the peak. Height means only what here? It is considered as amplitude. And what will be the unit? As this you are measuring, means on this graph you are measuring what? Density and pressure you are measuring. So unit will be also related to the density or pressure. As the pressure unit you all know, that is Newton per meter square. Okay, so this amplitude we have considered. Now we will see the speed. As we have studied that wave, it moves. Okay, wave is moving, means what? Wave is traveling, it will have some speed. So here, as it is moving with the speed, so we are going to consider here velocity over here, v. Speed means we are going to consider here v for the speed. So for this wave, what will be the speed? Okay, means with how much distance the wave has traveled per unit time is the speed of the wave. So here the unit will be, as the velocity, it is meter per second. Now the fifth term of related to this graph is the time period. What is the time period? Very simple. How much the wave has traveled, how much one wave has traveled per unit time. Okay, that is the time period. Time period means how much the time is needed for a wave to travel, that is called as time period. It is denoted by letter T, and the unit is second. Okay, here time is measured in seconds. So these were the characteristics of sound wave, because we are considering all it related to the waves. Now here most important part, you can see here if you will see above this line and below this line, the graph is divided. Okay, these are the higher density, higher pressure peaks. Okay, so as it is above, it has higher densities, higher pressure. These are called as crest, means the peak which is above the line. Okay, and if you will see the peaks which you have drawn below the line, that is low frequency, low density, they are called as troughs. Okay, these are again the new names which represents the compression and rarefaction in the graph. Okay, so these all you have studied about the characteristics of sound waves. Now you are going to study the relation between frequency and time. Time, here you can see this is the nu equal to 1 upon t. Okay, here I will draw it properly so that you can identify that it is nu. Nu equal to 1 upon t, that is frequency equal to 1 divided by time period, means it is inversely written. Okay, and otherwise if you want to find the time t equals to number of frequency. Okay, if 5 waves are given, if you want to find the one wave, then what it will be? What it will be? 1 divided by 5. Okay, similarly here nu equal to 1 divided by time t. So now you are going to study the characteristic of sound. Here it was the characteristics of sound wave. Don't get confused between the characteristics of sound wave and characteristics of sound. Okay, waves means in wave all these characteristics, all these five characteristics are present, and in the characteristic of sound these three qualities are present, three characteristics are present, that is pitch, loudness and quality. These are the characteristics of sound you are going to study. So first one, what is pitch? You have listened many times, you have listened the high pitch, low pitch, all this thing you have listened. Okay, so what is actually high pitch, low pitch sound? If in musical competition you have listened, your pitch was very high, your pitch was low. Okay, so means what? That within here you can see, this can indicate the high pitch, means at a particular time if you are extending your waves, means more number of frequency is there. Okay, in a per unit time, if more frequency is there, then it is high pitch. And low pitch means if you are singing very low pitch, means what you are doing, with a particular period of time the waves are also small, means the frequency is small or less frequency with respect to the time period. So here this can indicate if the pitch of a sound is high, then your frequency will be more frequency, as if you compare to the low frequency. In low frequency you will see time period is same over here, this and this time period is same, but in high pitch more frequency is there, but in low pitch less frequency. Okay, if low pitch sound and high pitch sound. Now here you can see the loudness. What is loudness? If some people is talking in loud voice, small voice, what is loudness? Now here, if we are banging small, slowly on our table, so how you can see? You can see a soft sound, you can hear a soft sound. But if you are banging the table hardly, that time how you can hear? You can hear a louder sound, means how much force you are applying for hitting the table. Okay, means how much force you are emitting or hitting the table, that will show the louder sound, or how slowly it can be considered for the sound. means if any loudspeaker is there, if the sound is very slow, if you have kept a little bit sound, so you can see the soft, you can hear the soft sound. But if you have increased the volume, what you can see, what you can hear the louder sound. So this sound or the louder and soft sound, it depends upon amplitude. This part is very, very important. Loudness determines by amplitude. Okay, this many students get confused over here. Here pitch is related to the frequency and loudness is related to the amplitude. Okay, here you can keep in mind PF. This is a short term, you can keep in mind PF. You can see here PF means pitch frequency and LA. This way also you can keep in mind. LA means loudness, sound, pitch and frequency. Pitch is related to frequency, loudness is related to amplitude, because this is a very important part of this point. Okay, so this is how your loudness, softness determines. Okay, now you can see here, this was the graph for the pitch, now this is the graph for the loudness. If you are making a small sound, okay, means in a loudspeaker, you are making a small sound, okay, you have rotate the knob for to make the sound smaller. So means what actually you are doing, you are working on the amplitude. Means as you have studied, amplitude means what? It is the height from the main position to the maximum displacement. So if you are making the sound to the minimum, means you are reducing the amplitude. Okay, and if you are increasing the amplitude of, if you are increasing the sound, okay, loudness of sound means what you are doing, you are increasing the amplitude. Okay, understood? So this is how loudness depends upon the amplitude. If you want to make a sound at minimum, means you are reducing the amplitude. If you want to make it louder sound, you are increasing the amplitude. Okay, as you know, if there is any celebration in your house, and if you want to play the music and you have not attached the speaker, just you are playing the music on CD player, okay, is it able to reach the sound? Will the sound reach at a higher distance? No. For that purpose, what you have to do, you are using the loudspeakers or amplifiers. Amplifiers means what? They are amplifying. Means if this is the voice of your CD player, if you are using the amplifier, means what you are doing? You are increasing this amplitude. So if you have connected the loudspeakers, amplifying means you are increasing the amplitude of the sound so that you can hear a loud sound. Okay, so this was related to the loudness of the sound. And third characteristic is the quality. Now quality of the sound, now as you know, you can recognize the sound. Here also loudness means some, if I am, I will teach you in low voice, what happens? You are not able to listen. If I am talking in high, means your loudness depends. Okay, similarly here quality is the third characteristic. In quality, many small terms you are going to study. Quality means what? Now if you are playing a beautiful music, okay, it is very pleasant for your ears, you are enjoying that music, means what? It is enjoying that. Okay, so it is called as music. Okay, the pleasant sounds for our ears, it is called as music. And how the music has how the quality of the music is, it is the rich quality. The quality is rich for the music. And what is the quality for the noise? In the class, you all are making noise. Okay, that time what will be the quality? The quality will be how? Noise means it is not rich quality, the quality is low quality, and it is unpleasant also. You are not able to listen, or the noise which you are making, it is unpleasant for someone's ear. So this unpleasant sound is called as noise. Okay, so music and noise you have studied. Now some terms are there which is called as tone. What is the tone of your sound? Okay, this all things you are calling. Tone means what? Single tone, single frequency means what? Single wave. In a piano, when you press one button, you can hear only one tone sound. Okay, that is the tone. And if you are pressing many buttons together, okay, many different buttons you are pressing together, what happened? There is a mixture of such frequency, several frequencies. Each button has a different frequency. If you are pressing all the buttons together, what happened? You are making it differently. Okay, so it is the mixture of several frequencies. So, or what it is called as note. Okay, and these are the few characteristics of sound. And one more interesting characteristic. Now, you all are able to identify, if you are closing your eyes and you are able to identify the sound of a man and woman. Okay, if you are closing your eyes and if two persons are talking, one man and one woman is talking, if you are closing your eyes, you can identify that this sound is of female and that sound is of male. How you can identify? It is because of the pitch. Okay, it is because of pitch. Now, one more example I want to give about quality. Quality means every person has some quality of their voice. Okay, now if I am talking and if other teacher is talking, okay, you all are sitting in the class and me and myself and one more teacher, we both are talking outside the class, but you can identify that our both voice, you can identify now that this voice is of our teacher and that voice is of other teacher. Okay, so this way also you can identify. How you can identify? Because you are able to identify the quality of the teacher's voice. So this is how the everyone has the different quality of sound. Okay, one more topic I want to talk with you, that is the intensity of sound. Now everyone consider that loudness means intensity. What you can say, just increase the volume or just make the sound louder. Or you can say also say that just increase the intensity of the sound. Actually it is not. Okay, intensity and loudness is not the same term. Okay, here intensity is different and loudness is different term. Okay, so if you have any doubt, feel free to ask. Thank you.